I'm Joshua Bardwell, and you're going to learn something today. Today, we're talking about vibration isolation. Vibration isolation is more important now on our quadcopters than it ever has been. That's not entirely true. It's as important as it used to be, would actually be a more accurate thing to say. We used to vibration isolate our flight controllers way back in the days of multi-Wii, and then when mini quads got invented, we kind of stopped doing it. We hard-mounted our flight controllers. And the reason for that was that with smaller props, 5-inch props, and higher speed motors, the vibrations that the copters were experiencing were so high frequency that they didn't really affect the gyros that we were using very much. But gyros have gotten more sensitive and PID control algorithms have gotten more sophisticated. We're doing 2 kilohertz, 8 kilohertz sampling now, you know, much less filtering, much more sophisticated filtering, yada, yada, yada. The bottom line is that today, vibrations are back to affecting our flight controllers, and they didn't used to. And it might be easy to get a little bit mad about that, right? Why isn't that a step backward? But let's not forget that our quadcopters fly way, way, way better than they ever did. So it's not like we didn't get something for that trade-off. So I recommend that you soft mount your flight controller. I do it on basically every one of my builds. If you don't do it and you get away with it, good for you. But if you ever have problems like mid-throttle oscillation, like any weird unexplained oscillations or twitching, the very first thing that I always suggest that people do is I ask, have you soft mounted your flight controller? And if not, you need to do it. So then the question is, what's the best way to soft mount your flight controller? And one thing that people do is they put O-rings on the screws, the mounting screws, and that's not the best way to do it. One reason it's not the best way to do it is that the O-rings are not necessarily, they're kind of thin, and they're not always made of the right material, especially if you didn't buy like nicer, softer O-rings. But the real reason it's not the best way to do it is because the screws themselves transmit vibration. And even if you put the O-rings on the top and the bottom of the flight controller board, the screw is passing through the hole in the board. It's going to touch the hole in the board, and it's going to transmit vibrations that way. If you look at what the race flight guys have done with the Revolt V2, and they have the gummies, they've oversized the holes, they put these silicone gummies in the hole, that's a great way to completely isolate the board. But that only works if your board has these oversized holes in the gummies, right? So what are the rest of us supposed to do? Well, this is what I think is the best way to vibration isolate your flight controller. What we're looking at here is a vibration isolation mount. It's got a tapped hole on one side and a screw on the other side. Basically, this replaces the nylon standoff that you normally would use to mount your flight controller. And the great thing about this is that it completely isolates the flight controller from the vibrations of the copter. There is no solid surface at all. There's no screw. There's nothing passing through there. It's just the rubber. I've been using these on my copter for several months now, and they work great. I even use them to mount the Revolt V1 on my Racelite 1 copter when I accidentally blew up the Revolt V2 board by putting voltage where it shouldn't have been. Oops, that's on me. The V1 board that I had was not drilled out, and I couldn't use the gummies, and I used these, and they work pretty good. If they work on the Revolt with its 32 kilohertz sampling, then they'll probably work on your copter too. Don't let the fact that this guy has this is not the one that you're ordering when you order the 8mm by M3-1. This is a giant one. This is the one you get looks more like this. Oh, hey, in fact, it looks very, very similar to this. Here's another listing. Now, the listing I'm showing you here is from Global Industrial. This is where I ordered mine from. This Banggood listing didn't exist at the time. It cost 87 cents a piece. I can vouch for these. I've been using them. I can tell you that they're effective, but they're a little bit more expensive, as you might expect, than the Banggood ones. On the flip side, if you're in the United States, this one comes from within the United States. You don't have to wait for it to come from overseas. These ones are $279 for four, so they're a fair whack cheaper, especially if you're going to order a bunch of them. I can't in any way vouch for these in terms of their vibration isolation. Is it a soft rubber? Is it a hard rubber? I don't know, but it is a product listing. It's listed as an anti-vibration, and it's probably worth spending $3 and a little bit of shipping to give it a try if you feel like ordering from Banggood instead of from this source. Oh, there they are. There they are. See, they're not bobbins. These aren't bobbins. Oh, anyway, there you go. I should point out that another place you can get them is Ready-Made RC, which I've got up here if you want to order from the U.S. How's the price here? Let's see. Where's the price? $339 for four, so it's a little cheaper than the Global Industrial. Again, I can't vouch for this product. I haven't used this specific one, but worth a punt as well. In my opinion, this is the single best way to vibration isolate your flight controller because it completely isolates it and because it integrates into how you were going to build the flight controller anyway. For example, another way to vibration isolate it is to use some kind of foam tape, right? Well, then you can't put anything underneath the flight controller like your receiver if you were so inclined to do that, or a 4-in-1 ESC. You just don't have the option. There's various other reasons why that's just not a great idea, in my opinion. It has all kinds of complications. This, you do the build exactly like you normally would, except instead of the nylon standoffs, you use the vibration isolating standoffs. If you go this direction, do be sure that you don't have too much. Like, don't just cram your receiver and a bunch of wires and other stuff underneath there that may also transmit vibration. A little bit of contact between some wires and the flight controller is probably okay, but if you have too much stuff crammed in there, especially on an ultra tight build like some of these really small racing copters, well, then you're not going to get the effect of the vibration isolation. Okay, and that's going to do it for this video. This is a short video and a simple video. I'm just telling you that this product exists, but I think it's an important video because so many people reach out to me with problems that boil down to vibration isolation. If you're having any kind of weird vibration, oscillation, a twitching that you just can't explain and can't tune out, and if you haven't vibration isolated your flight controller, that is absolutely the first thing you should do. This is true even if you have a flight controller with the 6000 gyro, which is, in my opinion, and also I think Boris's opinion, the best gyro for multirotors that's on the market today, the MPU 6000. That is not immune from noise issues. It's less likely to have them, but it's not totally immune. And if you have the 6500 or the 9250 gyro or some of these other newer gyros, which numbers don't come to my mind, all of those are more noise prone than the older gyro, the 6000 gyro and the 6050 that we used to use. So if you have those, I mean, again, I just do it as a matter of course on all of my builds because I think it's cheap insurance. If you feel a little bit angry and indignant, why do I have to soft mount? I never used to have to soft mount. That's the price we pay, I guess, for having quadcopters that fly as freaking good as our quadcopters fly. And they fly freaking good, don't they? So, yeah, suck it up, I guess is what I'm saying. Thanks for watching. Happy flying.